PBL is well known for its global integrated assessments, and we are able to combine information and trends about population, economic development, climate change, water and environment, and what it means for people. And our knowledge, we would like to combine it with other organizations and people who are working in the security and migration domain. And we focus on drylands because that's one of the major hotspots in the world when it comes to migration and security.
The drylands cover 41% of the world's land surface, and 2.8 billion people lives on them, mainly like 90% in developing countries, but not only. For example, dryland covers 17 states of the US.
UNCCD is working on addressing the root causes of migration and conflict in two main ways. One, on helping the countries to mobilize the resources to create new jobs through land rehabilitation, and the second one, by supporting the global agenda in including on migration, in including the drivers of migration like climate change and land degradation.
For those who are able to move, they'll be able to move and go to look for other opportunities. But how about those who are not able to move? What do we do with them? So these are where we talk about the issue of the vulnerable community or the marginalized, the people who might not be able to move, the youth, the disabled, the poor. Our focus is these individuals in the community.
CODED's work in Horn of Africa in regards to climate change involves building community capacities to be able to anticipate the risks which are caused by climate change, to be able to adapt to these changes and also respond, because they are the first people to respond in terms of disasters, and also to be able to transform their livelihood to be able to be resilient in the long term.
By 2050, 1.4 billion people will be living in urban areas and they need food. And you know, in urban areas, people don't plant food. And we see all the cities coming up in Africa, over 10 million people aggregating in certain spaces. It compounds the problem of food sourcing, food availability, food distribution.
Africa's population in the future is projected to double in the next 20 years. This will result in very large cities. People living in these cities need access to food. Unfortunately, urbanization is eroding away where food can easily be obtained. Therefore, in order to ensure availability, access, and utilization of food in urban areas of Africa, we need to now embark on a project called AgroOps.